students, today we are going to start with interesting grammar topic, that is direct and indirect speech. Students, we can report the speech of a person in two ways. Means whatever the person has said, we can report it to the third person in two ways. First is by reporting the exact words of the speaker. That is known as what? Direct speech. Means whatever the person has said, we are reporting it as it is. And the other way is by reporting the words. Means we give substance to the words said by the speaker. That is known as what? Indirect speech. Now, example of that. Tom said, I am going home. Now, whatever Tom has said, I have repeated the exact words. So, it becomes direct speech. Now, the same sentence. Tom said that he was going home. Here in this sentence, whatever the Tom has said, I have changed the words, I have changed the tense, I have changed the pronoun. So it becomes indirect speech. Here you have to keep in mind, there are certain rules for changing a sentence from direct to indirect. Before that, it becomes very important for you all to know two parts of a sentence. Now see here. In direct speech, a sentence has two parts, that is reporting speech and reported speech. Now, here, Tom said, I am going home. In this sentence, the part which comes before the comma is known as what? Reporting speech. Same here, I said to my mother, comma. The part which comes before the comma is known as what? Reporting speech. And the part which comes after the comma or which is in inverted comma is known as what? Reported speech. See here. Here also, I am going home. It is in inverted comma. So it will become reported speech. Keep in mind, the part which is before the comma is known as what? Reporting speech. And the part which is in inverted comma is known as what? Reported speech. Now, the part which is before the inverted comma, that is known as what? Reporting speech. Reporting speech consists of subject, the reporting verb, and the listener. See, I said to my mother, I is subject, reporting verb is said, and my mother is what? Listener, because he is saying to mother. If you can also write, I said, I'll be late today. That is also okay. But if the listener is mentioned in the reporting speech, while changing into indirect, you will say, I told my mother. If the listener is not present in the reporting speech, you will say, I said that I would be late today becomes that day. That changes, I'll explain you further how it changes. Now see here, this example. Now, while changing from direct to indirect, five things you have to keep in mind. Now, here in this sentence, Tom said, I am going home. Indirect becomes Tom said that he was going home. Five changes I have made in this sentence. What are those changes? Just see here carefully. Remove punctuation. I have removed the inverted comma. See, I have removed a comma and inverted comma. I have changed the tense. The reported speech, this one which is in inverted comma, I have to change the tense of that part here. So I am going becomes he was going. Am becomes was. Change of pronoun, I becomes he, first person becomes third person, and comma becomes that. I have removed the comma, and instead of comma, I have joined it by conjunction that, and change of the words here. Tom said, I am going home. Tom said, I have removed the comma, I have joined it by conjunction that, first person becomes third person, am, is, am, are, present tense becomes past tense. And becomes was going home. Clear? In any sentence, when you are changing a sentence from direct to indirect, children, you have to keep these five changes in mind. It is very important here. Now, see, as I told you, this present tense becomes past tense. In the same way, here we'll see each tense. If the sentence is in simple present, it becomes simple past. If it is present continuous, is, am, are, and ing of the verb. Like, I am writing, my mother is cooking. It becomes past continuous. I was writing, my mother was cooking, like that. Present perfect means has or have is changed to had. Present perfect continuous becomes past perfect continuous means has or have been is changed to had been. Simple past becomes past perfect, like had plus past participle of the verb. Past continuous, was or were, becomes past perfect continuous, and past perfect and past perfect continuous, there is no change. If in the direct speech we have shall, then indirect it becomes should, will becomes would, can becomes could, and may becomes might. This also you have to keep in mind. All these changes, children, this simple present to simple past, present continuous to past continuous, at the end I am going to do it with example. So don't worry about that. I have just explained here in short, but now I am going to do in detail. Before that, you have to keep in mind, if your sentence is universal truth, habitual fact or a proverb, that time the tense of the reported speech will not change. See, as I told you here at the start only, that whenever you are changing from direct to indirect, the tense of the reported speech will change. But now what I am telling you all, if your sentence is universal truth, habitual fact or a proverb, the part of a sentence in inverted comma is habitual truth, universal truth, habitual fact or a proverb, that time you will not change the tense. See your example. See, he said every action has an equal or opposite reaction. This is what? This is universal truth. I cannot say he said that every action had an equal or opposite reaction. Has changes to had. But here, as this sentence is universal truth, I cannot change the tense of the sentence here. The tense of the sentence will remain as it is. I will only remove comma and inverted comma. I will just join it by the conjunction that. So it will become he said that every action has an equal or opposite reaction. Why I have not changed the tense of the sentence here? Because it is universal truth. Other example. She said architecture students visit monuments every Sunday. Now this is habitual fact. Architecture students every Sunday they visit monuments. So here also I will not change the tense of the sentence. I will just remove comma and inverted comma and I will join it by the conjunction that. She said that architecture students visit monuments every Sunday. Keep in mind, if it is universal truth, habitual fact or a proverb, I will not change the tense of the sentence which is in inverted comma. I will not change the tense. I will just remove comma and inverted comma and join it by conjunction that. Keep in mind, you have to read the sentence carefully. Now simple example. So one more example, like teacher said the earth is round. So this is also universal truth here. So I cannot change it. I will not say teacher said that the earth was round. I cannot change is into was here. It is a universal truth. It is a fact here. So I will not change the tense of the sentence. I will keep it as it is. Teacher said that the earth is round. I will just join reporting speech and reported speech by the conjunction that. I will not change the tense of the sentence. Keep in mind. The other thing, if the reporting verb is a present or future tense, the tense of the reported speech will remain same. One more thing. See here, as I told you, universal truth, habitual fact or proverb, you will not change the part tense of the reported speech. Same is the case if the reporting verb is present tense or if it is future tense. Present tense, reporting verb ye hai. See here, what I have told you here. This is reporting verb said. So here what I am saying here, if the reporting verb is present tense or future tense, if it is says or will say, says is present tense and will say is future tense. Now see example here. The boy says, I am going home. So here what again I will do, I will not change the part of the sentence which is an inverted comma. I will not change the tense here. I will keep it as it is. I will just join it by the conjunction that. The boy says that he is going home. I will not write is becomes was, am becomes was here, but I will not change because the verb, reporting verb is in present tense. If the reporting verb is in present tense, you will not change the part of the reported speech. You will just remove the inverted comma. You will change the pronoun here and join it by the conjunction. Just change the pronoun. Don't change the tense, children. The boy says, I am going home. The boy says that he is going home. Now, Harry will say, I haven't brought my book. Here again, it is future tense. Will say, reporting verb is in future tense. So again, same thing. I will just remove the inverted comma. I will join it by conjunction that. I will change the pronoun, but I will not change the tense. So Harry will say, I haven't brought my book will become, Harry will say that he hasn't or he has not brought his book. Understood? You will not change the tense, only join it by the conjunction that, remove the inverted comma and change the pronoun if the reporting verb is in present tense or future tense. After that, the personal pronouns or possessive adjectives of the first and the second person change to third person. See here, Tom said to me, I know you very well. So it will become, as I told you, if your reporting speech has a listener also. See, Tom is subject, said is reporting verb, and me is listener here. If the reporting speech is no what, it has a listener, then you will write told here. So Tom said to me will become Tom told me, joined by the conjunction that, I becomes he, first person becomes third person. No becomes new. Very well. Tom told me that he knew me very well. Farha said, my house is far away. Sorry, I forgot to write here away. Farha said, my house is far away. Same sentence. Farha said that, I'll remove inverted comma, join it by conjunction that, my becomes her. My becomes her. Her house is becomes was far away. Understood? Personal pronouns and possessive adjective will change from first and second person to third person. That you have to keep in mind. Now, see here. The words expressing nearness will of place and time will change to words expressing distance of place and time. See, now becomes then. This becomes that, these becomes those, here becomes there, come becomes go, today becomes that day, tomorrow becomes the next day, yesterday becomes the previous day, ago becomes before, thus becomes so, and hence becomes thence. This you have to learn, you have to keep in mind. Example, the manager said, I am busy now. So, by changing the same sentence into indirect speech, you will write, the manager said that I becomes he. First person becomes third person. Present tense becomes past tense. And now becomes then. The manager said that he was busy then. All the changes, all five changes you have to keep in mind. The boy said, I left my bag here an hour ago. The boy said that I becomes he. Past tense become past perfect tense. Left becomes had left. His bag, my becomes his. Here becomes there. Ago becomes before. So the boy said that he had left his bag there an hour before. After that, if your sentence in direct speech is a question at that time, now, till here, what we have seen, whatever the reporting verb, if it is said, we will write said that. If it is present tense, we will write says that. If it is future tense, will say, if we write will say that. But now, if your sentence in direct speech is a question, by changing into indirect speech, instead of that reporting verb, instead of this said, it will, the reporting verb will change to asked, inquired and wanted to know. We can write she asked or she wanted to know, she inquired, like that. You cannot write she said that when it is a question. You have to use this any one of these words. Like see, for example, she said to me, where are you going? So you will write, she asked me where I was going. Clear? You have to, instead of reporting verb, you have to write asked, inquired and wanted to know, and change the tense and pronoun. Now, if your question is yes no question, this is WH question. So here you will change the pronoun, change the tense, and you just reporting verb, you will write asked, inquired or wanted to know. But if the question is yes no question, so you have to keep in mind, in that question you have to use the word if or whether in that. Like for example, he said, do you play tennis? So while answering, you will write, instead of said, because it is question, reporting verb will become asked. He asked, and it is yes no question. Do you play tennis? We can answer in yes I play or no I don't play. So if it is yes no question, you will use if then or whether. He asked if I play tennis, or he inquired whether I play tennis. Understood? She said to Rahim, will you help me? She asked Rahim if he would help her. You have to keep in mind, reporting verb will become asked, inquired, wanted to know. If the question is a yes no question, you have to use if or whether, any one of it. After that, if your sentence in direct speech is imperative sentence, means it is command or request sentence, so here also the reporting verb becomes requested, begged, ordered or commanded. See for example here, he said to the servant, wait here till I come back. Now usually what we do, we order the servant, we order something to the servant. So here, instead of writing he said to the servant, what you will write? He ordered the servant. Now while changing the imperative, means command or request sentence, into indirect, you have to write the reporting verb ordered, begged or wanted to know, this commanded, sorry. And this part of the sentence here, see, the one which is in inverted comma, while writing into indirect form, you have to pick up the verb and put that verb in infinitive. Infinitive is very simple. You have to just add the word to before the verb. So it will be, he ordered the servant to wait. Here becomes there, I becomes he, come becomes came. He ordered the servant to wait there till he came back. Keep the changes in mind, all five changes. I said to the teacher, please explain this lesson to me. Now this word tells you that we are making a request. The child, the student is requesting to the teacher. So here you will write, I requested the teacher. Here explain, this verb will become to explain. I requested the teacher to explain. This becomes that. Understood? I requested the teacher to explain that lesson to me. You have to keep in mind, when your sentence is a command or request sentence, that time here you have to write requested, order, commanded, begged, or according to the sentence. And this part of the sentence you have to start with the infinitive. It is very simple. You have to just add to before the verb, like to wait, to explain, that. Just add to before the verb. It is known as what? Infinitive. After that, if your sentence in indirect speech is a proposal or a suggestion, means a suggestion is made in a sentence, here let is used. So that let, what you will do, change to propose or suggested, and you have to also use the word should. See example here, she said to us, let us watch TV. See, the word let is used. It shows that you are someone is suggesting you something. So here what you will do? Here you will use the word suggested or proposed, and you will also use the word should. शी सजेस्टेड टू अस दैट अस बिकम्स वी एंड यू हैव टू यूज शुड वॉच टीवी. शी सजेस्टेड टू अस दैट वी शुड वॉच टीवी. आफ्टर दैट इफ योर सेंटेंस इज एन एक्सक्लेमेशन विश दैट टाइम द रिपोर्टिंग वर्ब विल चेंज टू एक्सक्लेम्ड प्रेज डिजायर्ड और विश. सीयर ही सेड टू मी मे गॉड ब्लेस यू means you are giving you are praying for someone here to God. So here the reporting verb will be prayed. He prayed that God may becomes might. God might bless me. Now he said, alas, I am undone. So here what happened? This word shows what the person is sorrow. He is feeling sad. So here what with this reporting verb you can add sorrow with sorrow. He exclaimed with sorrow that he was undone. I becomes he, am become was. Understood? He exclaimed instead of said what I've written here. Exclaimed with sorrow because the word shows tells me the person is sad. So he exclaimed with sorrow. Then add the conjunction that he was undone. Now one more simple example. Like suppose I say he said, "Hurrah! I completed my work." Or I have won the game. So the same sentence while changing it into indirect, what I will write here? He exclaimed with joy. This word, suppose alas, as it shows sadness, the word hurrah, it shows the person is happy. So I will write, he exclaimed with joy that he has won the game. He had won the game. Clear? After that, now, as I told you, this one, at the start of this lecture only, I've told you the tense, that present tense change to past tense, present continuous change to past continuous. This table, I am going to discuss with you all with example now. See here. Simple present. Geeta said, I work in a bank. Now, this sentence in indirect form, present tense changed into past tense. So you, what you will do? Geeta said that. Remove inverted comma. Join it by conjunction that. First person becomes third person. Present tense becomes past tense. Geeta said that she worked in a bank. Now, if your sentence is present continuous tense. She said, I am doing my homework. Now, this sentence into indirect speech will become. She said that I become she. Am doing becomes was doing. My becomes her. She said that she was doing her homework. Present perfect becomes past perfect. He said she has washed the utensils. Has washed becomes had washed. He said that she had washed the utensils. Present perfect changes to past perfect. Present perfect continuous tense. Now he said, I have been living in Australia since 2013. It changes into past perfect continuous tense. Have been becomes had been. So it will be, he said that I becomes he, have been becomes had been. He said that he had been living in Australia since 2013. I have underlined the change so it becomes easy for you to understand. Simple past. She said, I bought a new dress. Simple past changes to past perfect. She said that I become she, bought becomes had bought a new dress. She said that she had bought a new dress. Past continuous. Geeta said, we were watching a movie. Past continuous becomes past perfect continuous. Geeta said that they had been watching a movie. Past continuous, were watching becomes had been watching. Keep in mind. After that, past perfect. Tom said, I had won the game. Past perfect will remain the same. Only pronoun will change. Tom said that he had won the game. After that, simple future. Will changes to would. Ravi said, I will go to America. Will change to Ravi said that he would go to America. Will becomes would. Future continuous will be changes to would be. Mary said, I will be baking a cake, will change to would be. Mary said that I become she, will be becomes would be baking a cake. Mary said that she would be baking a cake. Future perfect tense, will have changes to would have. Mona said, I will have cooked the food. Mona said that I become she, will have becomes would have cooked the food. Mona said that she would have cooked the food. Understood? See here children, I have underlined the year changes of the tense here in each sentence. I have told you the table also, how what changes to what, present to past and all. What are the other changes, like if it is let, you have to write propose, and should be used. If it is command or request, you have to write requested, ordered, commanded. You have to join it by the infinitive. Then if it is yes, no, you have to write if or whether in the sentence here. And if it is a question, you have to write inquired, asked, wanted to know. Here also, I have told you all the changes. So in detail, I have explained this topic to you all. This is video lecture. So you can pause and see again and again. You can write down the tenses, each tense example you can write down, and then practice other sentences according to you. This table is very important. You should know this table here, watch how the tense changes. So this also you can pause the video and note down the table, note down the other changes also, and practice the sentences from your textbook or other grammar book. If you have, you can practice the sentences. I hope you have understood this topic here. It is very easy. Any sentence, children, when you are changing from direct to indirect, just keep in mind, see whether you have made all these five changes. Remove punctuation, change the tense, change the pronoun, join by the conjunction that, and change of words. You have to keep in mind. And one more thing you have to keep in mind, that if the reporting verb is in present tense or future tense, and if it is junior, if it is present tense and future tense, you will not change the tense of the sentence. And the other thing, if it is universal truth, habitual fact or a proverb, that time also you will not change the tense of the sentence in reported speech. I hope you have understood. Go through the lecture again, revise all the rules and practice sentences. Thank you.